G'day everybody, and weirdly saying this on a stream, welcome to Survival Impossible, or welcome back for some more Survival Impossible. Feels so weird to do that on a stream. I am in the Survival Impossible world, I am on Omicron, but I am in creative mode, and I have invulnerability enabled, and I have a very handy new mod from Lucas that enables you to have infinite energy for your suit while you're in a survival game but in creative mode. It's kind of handy because normally when you're in survival mode with creative mode tools enabled, you end up running out of power constantly and your lights switch off and it's all just really annoying. So that's going to be super, super, super handy for that sort of, for this sort of purpose. Because I wanted to do this in creative mode so that I had all of the voxel tools available to me. I wanted to be able to place all the different types of rock, all the different types of snow, etc. So that I could really get into designing this stuff as best I can. But, of course, voxel hands are a bit awkward at the best of times. So I'm interested to find out how much of this is going to be an exercise in frustration more than cool little bits of design. Yes, survival is guaranteed for this one. Thanks, C Easy Miner. So with voxel hands, for those of you who haven't used them before, in your G menu, when you have creative mode tools enabled, you'll have the voxel hands set of tools here, and you can add them all to your hotbar like normal. But the thing that you really want to do if you want to get smooth creations with it is press K and turn off snap to voxel grid. Once you turn off snap to voxel grid, you can then create smooth edges if you are patient enough. So instead of this now, instead of this snapping to the grid that's underneath and having that kind of jagged, rough edges and no smooth terrain that you get with mining, because mining mines to the voxel grid, this will be perfectly smooth like the natural terrain. Well, like the good bits of the natural terrain. So, oh, that's why that was still pressurizing. So you might also, during this stream, get a little bit of a sneak peek at what I've started recording for the next episode of Survival Impossible, because I did a bunch of recording yesterday, which will go into the episode, and I'm planning on potentially doing some more after today. Hey Tex, how's it going? I've also turned off assertive mods and reavers because I didn't really want to have to get my head around how I would deal with them while in creative mode tools and streaming. So this is just creative, chill, try and make things look all pretty. In fact, maybe I should start in the arboretum with this, because one of the things that I'd like to do is get rid of that snow over there. Quite a few people suggested that I should turn this into earth-like grass. I'm not sure how I feel about that. I kind of like the idea, because it then makes it really obviously different. But then I wonder how it'll look against the trees. I suppose I can try it, actually. I do have Steve recording right now, but I'm not sure how long that'll last if I ever need to do any quick loads, because I messed something up so badly that I want to redo it. Okay, get the tree back. So to change your material with voxel hands, it's the square brackets on your keyboard, and then middle mouse allows you to paint. So you can paint the voxels to a different type without changing any of their shape. How's this going to look? This is interesting. It's lucky I've got a full armor wall rather than something that rather than going with something skinny, because if you're going to do this stuff, it's next to impossible to get a neat edge that lines up with a wall. Yeah, you need those buffer zones, Dragnon, that's right. Get that bit. This is gonna be... I reckon this is gonna kinda look cool. I could have almost done it a bit of both. There we go. I'm very happy to get rid of this snow though, since it's indoors. I'm amazed I'm able to paint around the... Oh, probably because I'm painting. That's why the little ore drop pod isn't stopping me from doing stuff. I was thinking of putting some little dirt paths around here so it looks like a little park as well. So that it's not... And also so that this edge is more dirt than... having the grass sticking up through the steel plate. There we go. I reckon that looks kind of cool. And I think it's like bear grass. Yeah, there we go. Grass bear. Oh. No, I don't think I want grass bear. Rocks grass. Grass old. Ooh. A little bit patchy. Yeah, this is going to be really obvious from outside. In fact, spectator cam. Okay. Let's have a look. Oh, dead grass under the pod. I love that idea. More subtle than you'd think. Because of the tinted window being outside, it is a bit more subtle. What about at night? We'll have to wait and see, because I've got the time-lapse running. I don't want to mess with the time of day too much, if I can help it. But yeah, at nighttime it should be more obvious, because it's all lit up from the inside rather than reflecting the bright outside. Yeah, there are so many things I have to be careful not to do because of having Steve recording time-lapses. What else we got? Grass old bear. Grass two. What's grass two? That's just basically a bare ground. Oh, woods grass. That's what I wanted. Yeah. So that's going to be another different texture as well. It's not all this perfect green. Thanks, XE6. Yeah, the projected tree misses bits. If you guys have... If any of you have watched Survival Maybe, you would have seen that when I had the global projection, what I had was a sensor turning it on and off as I left and entered the room, because if it remains on when you leave a space, a projector will kind of break a bit. And so you'll only see part of the projection. So you need to kind of keep it switching on and off all the time. And so I did that in Survival Maybe to try and get it to be a bit more, what's the word I'm looking for? A bit more consistent when I showed up and actually looked at it. Oh yeah, if I do this. Get rid of the grass that's under the edge. Yeah, Gannett. I am planning on eventually getting to all of the planets. In this 52 weeks, 1 year episode that's coming this week, you'll hear me talk a bit about my plans of where I'm gonna, what I want to do in the next year of Survival Impossible, and how I want it to feel a bit different, because this base is getting pretty close to effectively being complete. Or at least complete enough for me to use it as a safe harbor for me to explore further out. See you, Tex. Plus, at the moment, one thing to note is that Omicron is the only place that I know of where I can get magnesium. So there's going to be reason for me to keep coming back, which is something I'm happy about. Bandolier, long running with Capac. I want to do some sort of medium-term stuff with Capac. We both kind of like... prefer the idea, if we can come up with a way to make it work, of doing some sort of wrong way down length stuff. Sort of 6 months maybe in duration, that sort of time frame. Something that's a bit more manageable and allows us to keep trying new ideas, but can still be long, like reasonably long running, and have those longer arcs and things like that. I think it'll work a bit better. And I've got a few ideas of what we're going to do for that. Capac's aware of most of them. He's not aware of what I'm going to do in the next Space Engineers thing we do together, but he's got some ideas. I reckon that little curve looks alright. No, not challenge-based stuff. More like, oh, I suppose if you call Wrong Way Down or Grand Tour challenge-based, but something that has a clear endpoint that we should be able to reach over the course of a couple of months. So that's kind of the time frame I'm thinking of. I should have said that this chat, that this stream will be a good opportunity to ask lots of questions about this stuff, because probably will be, since most of this is going to be me just trying to get the voxel hands to do what I want them to do, which is not easy. It's fine if I'm just painting like this, but once I start actually digging space out, this is going to be hard. Survival Unlikely is not dead. I am working on the finale. And after that, Capac and I will be back together in some other things. It's just that I love Survival Unlikely, just like I love Survival Maybe. And I really, really, really set my expectations high for what I want the finale to be. And have possibly set those expectations so high for myself that I'm struggling to achieve what I want in a reasonable time frame. Light Echoes is another thing that's kind of been on hold while I've been working on Survival Unlikely, but Capac and I have made small progress on it this year. Oh, geez, that's horrible to say. But yes, this year. And definitely want to continue working on it. Neither of us are anywhere close to giving up on it, even though we've been struggling hard to get anything done. Yeah, Codon, organically developed paths do tend to go straight to point of interest with a little bit of a squiggle. But parks don't tend to have organically developed paths. If you're going straight from the seating, you'd probably just go straight down the stairs and down the stairs. But if you're going to the pod, or if you're going to go sit under the trees, you'll walk around this way. What was my thinking? Do you know what's really annoying? You can't place these couches in voxels at all. So I was hoping to be able to get like and like put a couch up here so you could sit under the tree, but you can't do it. They are a block that has to be completely clear of voxels. Just crazy and sad. Whoa, thanks so much, XC6. And thanks, Yestergear. It's not a small grid issue. The chairs are large grid only. It's a static grid thing, but you can't place them in voxels at all. Oh yeah, that's true, Mickle Moose. I probably could place it down and then use voxel hands to cover it up. Oh yeah, that would be cool, zeroed up, being able to put paving stones in the path. What do you guys think? How's this looking? Oh, thanks, DC Viper. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this. It's got enough variation that it's not just a big sea of bright, vivid green. It needs a swing. I'd love to do that. Oh, Dragnon, you crazy man. Thank you so much for the stupidly large pile of gift subs you've given. Right, so that's the easy bit. Because that's just painting. That's just middle mouse painting. Now for the tricky bit. And the bit that might need a little bit more planning. Oh, Matcha! Thanks as well, man. So, I need a path in the snow coming from this door and going up to the main building. Oh, actually, before I forget, so a suggestion I got in the comments for what I could do with this hole in the ground, instead of having these interior plate covered in snow, someone suggested I put ice in there, like voxel ice, perfectly flat, but just below the height of the snow. What do you guys reckon? Oh yeah, while I'm in creative mode, I might do something that I can't really do in survival. Let's go. Let's do this. F8. And here we go. Okay, we're now underneath the thing. What I'm going to do is grab this, which is it's a particle emitter. But I can't build the tool that I need to make this mod work. Because I need to damage this block so it has less than 50% health. So if I just cheat a little and get a rapid fire rifle, that's what I need. Oh, Ufol's saying I have to point it up. Ufol made this mod. Oh, is the stream being a bit funny? I wasn't sure whether my stream rig had handled recording in 4K and streaming in 1080p. Alright, I will stop the recording and we'll just use the stream. And hopefully that should smooth things up. That'd be better for you guys. It looks fine on the stream rig's end of things and it's not showing any drop frames. Is that enough damage? No. Yes? You fall. Is that enough damage? Yeah, what I'm seeing on my... Oh yeah, it's working. Okay, we've got some little fireflies now. Let me just do a stop stream and a restart, and we'll see if that fixes it, because... Yeah, everything is showing 100% normal on my end, guys. Sorry about this. So, this is Ufol's, Fireflies mod. Can you guys... Might be a little... low quality on the stream, maybe, but you might be able to see those little glowing balls around the place. Which I reckon is kind of cool. It's a nice little effect for the farm. I mean, the farm, the, the greenhouse. Yeah, a nice touch of movement and life that's... Because we got the trees moving, we got the grass moving, and now we've got the little bits of fireflies. Alright. That you are thirsty warning is going to get annoying. Okay. Let's change to snow. Thanks, Chibi. Ah, take a save. Maybe that's a good idea. There we go. I'm going to need to dig out a little bit, at least. Snow for this. Oh, some of the fireflies make it outside, but that's okay. It's not too obvious. And then, let's start by filling this up. Because you definitely get snow collecting in there. That's what I wanted to try and do. Maybe I'll do it now while I remember it. I want to try and create icicles. See if I can manage to make something that looks a bit like icicles. Yeah, I'm leaning towards a tunnel, like a bit of a trench in the snow, and then putting a different texture along the bottom of the trench. Just really difficult angle to work at. This one. Yeah, I was thinking more like stalactites. Stuff I was thinking for the icicles, hanging them off just the corners around here Because that'd look really cool, I think. Yellow snow. No, I'm not doing yellow snow. I just gotta try and fix these lighting weirdness goes on here. Hang on, I should turn off my headlights. Yeah, I'm thinking bet. Let's put the dirt in and just see what it looks like. Oh, look, moon soil. It's moon soil. Maybe not. Where's alien soil? Alien. Oh, I've got all the different alien soil. There we go. Handily, the shininess of this might work. Is that going to be too much? Yeah, I might need to switch back to snow and paint the edges in. This is such a fiddly process, isn't it? You can kind of see just how much time it must have taken to do the frostbite scenario and things like that. It looks like your wastewater tank sprung a leak. Yes, it does. Yeah, the moon texture might work as well. I kind of want to start with this path actually, because it's going to be an easier, whoops, it's going to be an easier one to work with, the path that runs between these two doors. Maybe I'll start with that. What I was tempted to do with the paths was actually build up snow around them, but I think it works better if I dig. Oh, I'm gonna need to fill in some of those gaps if I do that too high. Let's see. Yeah, little piles for the maintenance. I think I like that idea. Yeah, that feels kind of cool running along this as well. Pop a shovel somewhere. I kind of almost do feel like I need a mod to add some tools around the place. Extra little decorative bits. Drifts against the building. Which you might need to just sharpen up a little bit like this. Removing some. New vehicle idea of snowblower. Oh yeah, Dragnon, I should build something to pretend that it did all this snow moving idea. Something like that. To go in against this. How's this looking from above? Oh yeah. Yeah, I think it needs something in the path, doesn't it? Because the white doesn't really have enough contrast. Alright. Alien yellow grass, alien yellow grass bear, snow, soil. I think that alien soil's just a bit much, isn't it? Like, I know we're on Omicron, which is the alien planet, but I feel like if you were making a path, you probably wouldn't leave it looking like this. Yeah, it's kind of shiny mud. What does Triton stone look like? Ah, here we go. Yeah, I was thinking like gravel. That's kind of what I was imagining with this. It looks like someone's laid down gravel. It looks like you spray painted the floor. Yes. It's very hard to get any sort of nice edge with voxels in Space Engineers. The voxel tools don't quite give you what you need. Because even if I use a small tool like this to try and bring it out, it doesn't quite work. Yeah, that didn't help. That didn't help at all. Blend. Oh, what about this? Because this still looks like it's snow covered, but just a bit more stuff underneath exposed. Like there's a bit of slush and stuff in it, so it's not clean snow. Yeah, that's the way to go. Heaps better. And I can put little patches of the rocky stuff in as well, just to give it a bit of variety. But I think I think this is the winner. How does that look from above? Well, thanks again, XE6. Crazy. The bits. Breakfold, the new wheel update has not come out yet. I am looking forward to the new wheel update. I am hoping it includes something that fixes wheels from popping, as well as the new decorative wheels, because I will probably take advantage of them. Oh, I'm gonna have to move all my vehicles to create the little parking bays for them. But I was thinking for the vehicle parking bays, so that they still have a smooth surface, I was gonna build up snow around them rather than digging them in like I've done for the walking tracks. Add a few more bits to around the walls. Make it look like the buildings have been here a little while. Now, my experience with snow is obviously going to be less than some other people's, being from where in the world I am. Oops, that's going to need to be fixed. But I have some idea of where it should end up. Can I make it snowy in the corner of a window? That would be cool. Let's try this. So I'll start by just filling in the window with a bit of snow, and then I'll see how much I can cut out and how it looks with a tiny bit left. Get it on the other side of the glass. How's this? Might need to get rid of a bit of the top, I think. It's a bit more outside, doesn't it? This. Clear from the bottom. Oh, this is delicate. Oh no! Dang it. Don't link up. Don't want you linked. You separate. That does look kind of cool, doesn't it? I think it's as good as you're going to get it. I don't know that the hand drill will work better than this. Yeah, in terms of the volume I remove, yeah, sure, yeah, it will. But in terms of getting smooth surfaces, it can't do what I can do with the voxel hands tool. Do I think hollowing out an assertive drone blueprint and painting them icy would look good left partially under a snowdrift drop? Snowdrift. Yeah, Ragnarok, I think something like that could be good, but I'm kind of going to focus more on my base as my base rather than trying to add extra stuff like from the mods and things. Yeah, H2O Marco, this is the smallest circular brush, which ends up being the nicest brush to use. Because this pill brush is the same size. This cube brush is smaller, but it gives weird edges. So, happy with that. I might just see if I can manage to blend up to the surface a little bit. Maybe a bit more needs to be cut out. Just smooth that. Come on. Be smooth. Okay. And we'll go back to the Triton blend. And bring that up onto the surface, like that. Yeah. Try my hands at an igloo / snow fort and a snowman. Yeah, Packet Sender, this will be going up on the Flipsy channel as usual, and depending on how it looks from Steve's perspective and how long Steve's perspective lasts, this should go in the time-lapse as well. Snow back. That's a bit much. There we go. Yeah. That's working all right. You can use the wheel tracks into the building bay as the path too. Yeah, the vehicle paths is what I'm not sure how to do. Because I think digging them out might get a bit excessive. Let's have a look. Do I dare click a Daily Mail link? Oh, sure. That. Interesting. Don't want to click myself back in and accidentally drop some voxels somewhere. I don't want them. So I'm thinking... Yeah, snow path, that's what I was doing against the edges. I was figuring that the snow would have been blown up against the edges here. Might do a taller bit in one spot, just so it stands out a bit more. And then go inside and clear up what I just added inside the building. Welcome to Space Engineers Canada Edition. Yep. I mean, should I say sorry? Okay. I might just go around the production building first before I start getting into other stuff. Make it done. Yeah, Dragnon, I'm not a big fan of the cold, but I did very much enjoy my time in Canada, because I've had a Christmas in Canada before. And it was fun. It was kind of weird sticking a beer outside the door and having it turn into a beer slushy because I left it out there too long. And the concept of using the outdoors as your freezer, that's cool. Oh, I can't place boxes there, won't let me. And it won't let me place them there either. I wonder what's on the other side that's blocking it. I suppose they don't need to be everywhere. Why are you not liking me at the moment? There we go. Seriously, something on the other side of this wall is blocking me from placing the voxels down. Seems. I realize I'm not clearly thinking about the wind having come in one direction when I'm doing this stuff, but I think it's unlikely that it'll be obvious that I've messed that up in the videos. You'll just see the snowdrifts in the background and it should look cool. Ah, thanks, Sam. Give me an excuse for just doing this as I feel like at the time. Yeah, the wind will get little flurries and go around and make messes in everywhere. I wonder if it's the chairs that are blocking me? Maybe, I don't know. I don't know. Let's have a look. How did that come out? Yeah. Happy with that bit. And leave a pair of boots at the door. Should I have a little bit of snow on the roof? Yes, yes, nope. Pole! Alright, let's do it. Duplicate. We will do a quick stream poll. Depending on the wind, wouldn't gather there much. That's fair. Should I have small snowdrifts on the roof? Yes. No. And let's not do a spam vote. Let's do a 2 minutes. Start. Can I do something? That. Oh, that's small. Interact. Oh, whoops. Is that visible for you guys? Do I need to make that bigger?
That works.
Looks like most people are saying yes. It'll look really funny once you teleport the building away again. There's snow on the roof. Yeah, so what I was thinking in terms of a little bit of snow on the roof was maybe a little drift up again, like a little bit, just tiny bits against, say, the base of the turret and around the base of the turbine. Not in any way to block incoming gunfire. Good point, Sloshmonger. I don't want to end up cheating with it. Okay. So where could I put it? Maybe this roof can't have any, but that roof can. May also count against... Oh! The poll says yes. Poll says yes, but people have given me very good reasons not to that hadn't been thought about. Hang on. I can check if it counts against wind generation. Let's do a little bit of that. So that is now producing 27 kilowatts. Okay, it reduces it a heap. We get rid of that. And... Uh-oh. Why is that ferrying? Have I broken it? Oh dear. I might have broken my wind generation. Oh no, wait. That could be just how much they're putting out because my batteries are full. Turbine. Yeah, no. The max output is still there. Okay, you are going to be your wind turbine too. Alright, fine. I put a little bit of snow there. Does it make any difference to wind turbine 2? Max output 77.5. Max output 77.5. Right, where could I put snow here? This roof may not have been the best choice to start this on. I definitely think that that roof should have some against the edge of that ridge line down the middle, and the roof of the arboretum should too. Oh, that's fair, Bear Seeker. The power generation may not remain after restart. Dang it. I wanna... Alright. This roof, I'm not sure I can make it work. Because the round object doesn't really give me a nice leeward side to put stuff against. But... this building does. This must be a bit weird for you guys seeing this without me editing out the me running between places as much. So I was thinking I might put the snow along this side. But it won't let me. That's all it's letting me do. I can't. Alright, it's just going to be a little bit in the corners then. Oh, that didn't work. Wonder if it's not letting me place it in the middle because of the rotor that's underneath it. That's kind of all I can actually put in. Oh. Oh, you mean you want me to do this, Mike? I suppose I can try with a smaller brush. Get up the stairs. No, I can't fly, Beer Seeker. Because I left the survival less likely mod on, so my jetpack still doesn't work. Why haven't I changed this one block to a half ramp? I don't know! I didn't think about it, Karma's Evil Twin. That's a very good point. This should be a slope. Ah, I'll have to fix that. Hopefully I'll remember. Because yes, I should do that. Yeah, I could use Spectator, which I'm going to have to hear. Oh no, I won't. But the reason I'm not using Spectator is I find it harder to do voxel hands from Spectator. Or at least do it smoothly. Okay. That'll do. That's all I can do on that roof. Let's do this roof. Hopefully this roof will let me do a bit more. PhD, the reason I prefer the walking is the control system works better for what I'm trying to do here with natural appearance. One of the main reasons I tend not to use mods that change core vanilla stuff like the block edges is because I want people to be able to use any of my design ideas and take advantage of them even when they're playing purely vanilla. So I prefer to give myself those limitations so that I have to work with them as well, so that I don't have that big advantage in making things look good, because I feel like it's a bit of a crutch that you can end up relying on. Like, if you're an Xbox, if you're playing on Xbox and you're seeing me do this stuff that's only possible with this particular mod, it's a bit disappointing. That's why you see so much of what I do is quite heavily vanilla. That and making tutorials, I always preferred to play vanilla so that I knew what the vanilla game was. Gannett, no. I dislike pretty much every single weapon mod out there. They're OP and they make what is tissue paper armor even more tissue paper armor. It just, I've never found one that suits my playstyle with weapon mods. This needs to come out a bit. Let's get that down a bit. Cleared that whole bit because that looks like a vent. There we go. How's that look? Yeah. Under the stair would have snow. Okay. Should do that too. Yeah, I'm happy with this. This is definitely the roof that needed to have snow. I wish I could have put some more up on the garage though. Oh, I can tell the difference of that snow now. I need to change it back to alien. So I was using the wrong type. In this light, I can tell it's a bit bluish compared to the yellower alien snow. Let's clear that out. And just check that I haven't put too much snow inside the building. Like that. Yeah, Sam, having this extra detail with the voxels, I think, makes it look a lot more believable that everything has the rusty and snowy textures, because there's a bit more reason for it. They're not just clean, perfectly square blocks that happen to be rusty or snowy or frosty. Now I'm hoping this hasn't messed up the roof, because this is only a half slab block. No, a cube won't be better. The cube always ends up cutting it weirdly, Like, I always find that I get these sharper edges. Whereas using the sphere, I can tell exactly where it's getting close. And I'm just doing it flat against the roof. The very top of the sphere. I've always found it easier to use the spheres for this. Others may find different, but I genuinely find that the cubes are always just... They always end up creating little jaggies that I don't want. Oh, come on. Get rid of that a little bit. There we go. I know you can rotate it, but it doesn't make any difference. Anyone trying to convince me about the cubes? You are not going to be successful. I've done this before. It's not the first time, and I've never found it works as well. Gilgamesh, the ores on this planet are simply rare. Dang it! I thought that was going to happen. I've got to clear that out a bit to get rid of that horribleness. Because of the voxel grid. Skinny bits around here. Oh, that looks alright. I don't know that that's true, final event. I just sometimes choose not to listen. I don't know that it's always the right time, though. It's often not. Still, it's better than Capax, which is just never listen to me. It is an alien planet, so who knows when it snows, it doesn't come down in cubes. Yeah, it's entirely chance, Ragnarok, you are right. Snowman near Fort Capac. Man, I wish I could make a small enough snowman that it wouldn't be like, because realistically the only snowman you're going to make is with a body that's that big, and that's just going to be huge, unnecessarily large, which I might do for like a Christmas special or something. See you, Matcha. Where the arboretum and the building next to it meet, on the roof in the crevice, yes. You would get lots of snow in there, but I can't... Because it's a glass window, the snow will look really, really wrong. Because I don't have that buffer zone of the block to work with, so I won't be able to put snow there. Snowman mod. I think there are some Christmas mods that have snowman in them. Dragnon, with any of Lucas's mods, I don't need to worry about leaving places. It's when I come back that's the problem. They won't get attacked when I'm not there. How am I going to do this? I want to create little snowdrifts like it's been, this area's been plowed. I wasn't expecting that to happen. Dang it. Reloading time. Guess I gotta pick a new angle for Steve's time-lapse now. Either. Doesn't matter. Whichever one you would prefer. Yes, Splitzer kills another tree in a new and slightly less exciting way. Oh. Okay, lesson learned. Don't play with voxels near trees. I might try this with the cube one, just because I want it to be smaller. That is the wrong material. I didn't lose much work at all because I had saved just before I started doing this because I feared something would go wrong. And I was right. I would suggest you build a snowman for the holiday season, but it'd be upside down and need sunglasses. Yeah, I reckon my... what am I gonna do? I'm trying to think of where I can put Steve. That's why I'm away. My head's away from the microphone because I gotta reach my laptop. Maybe that'll do. Where is the hot tub gonna go? Don't like that. I don't know how I would achieve tire tracks. But I am going to put snow drifts on, like, around the place to try and make a bit of a road. So what I was thinking was... let's put lights on. Having a snow drift that runs around, so kind of with the tree, but then around and back here, so that there's snow that's been pushed up around the parking area. Then continuing it around the back of these two parking spots, and then kind of just tapering it off here, and having some rough tracks where these two parking spots are. What's under the big dirt pile? Splitsy number one or cat pack number? So yeah, I was planning on doing like a parking area and then having roads that run down to the airbase over there, and another road that runs down past the arboretum on the left and kind of tapers off to nothing. Interesting, Maxstorm. Still not particularly helpful with way I've set up Steve, because Steve is behind me about a meter because I don't have room, but could be useful with the stream rig, I guess. Right, so I might move Manny. Might as well park him away. Oh, I could let's not try and do that just yet. Let's see how much of the core decorative stuff. I was thinking I could make a road down to the snow mine. Oh, no. Went the wrong way. Man, I love this. Also, it's just reminded me something. It's always a bit red. Yeah, kind of a plowed row between the garages, that's what I was thinking. I need to move Goofy. He's to there. I might put your lights on. Too close to the tree. Okay, I'm putting my not listening to you guys on this cube thing earlier to me getting home from a night shift and making stupid decisions, because this is actually quite good for the snowdrifts. I take it back. But this isn't the first time I've had to take back my disagreements with PhD Composer. He's proved me wrong before. Should have known better. What do I remember it being so horribly bad that I just feared it? Yeah. Maybe I didn't know about the voxel grid toggle back then. It was before I discovered that. Oh, Mike, this isn't the... it's not that uncommon for me to admit that I was wrong. Is it? I mean, it is if it's Capac, but if it's you guys, it's not. It's the reason I read the comments. Does anyone else feel slightly concerned that me being able to ignore this O2 flashing warning might be a habit I don't want to develop? No, this sphere is as small as it can get. How is the flashing O2 not annoying you? I don't know, it just doesn't. I've always been quite good at ignoring such things. Here you go. I'll fix it. Thanks, Mike. Yeah, that drone leap was such a... I was so happy that I got that bit of that little bit of drama in there, because I was definitely going to be disappointed if my first death was something just a bit lame and dull. That there was some solid drama there very much made me happy. Are we taking bets on how many episodes until the vehicle gets hung up on one of those snowbanks? Oh man. Wait, there's a like a prediction thing you can do on Twitch. I haven't figured out how to actually do it, but you can do a poll where people enter their prediction of what's going to happen, as opposed to entering what they want to have happen. But I can't remember how to activate it. Because I haven't looked into it properly yet. Seriously, Broke? Did I predict that my first death was going to be dehydration? Oh, that's awesome. Oh, that's hilarious. I didn't realize that. No, the prediction polls are different because if you get the prediction right, it's kind of like a, well, it's gambling with channel points, basically. If you get the poll right, the prediction right, you get a portion of the stuff that was of the bits of the channel points, sorry, not bits, of the channel points that were put into the poll, and the losers get none of theirs back. So you actually get some of your channel points back. That's the difference with a prediction poll versus a poll. Don't want to do too much around there because I want to still be able to drive out and drive in easily. Just wanted to create another pile over here. Then let's go back to this and the transition blend thing. No, Max Tom, I've never used Stream Engineer, and when I last looked into it, I don't think it works anymore. Unless it's been fixed since when I last looked at it. But when I last looked at it, it didn't work. Stream Engineer, for those of you not familiar, is a Twitch integration for space engineers. Yeah, Kavak and I thought about doing something with it, so I looked into it, and yeah, it wasn't going to be an option. I think the Twitch integration with Stream Engineer adds. So you guys can make stuff spawn in and things like that. But Climb has made a custom Twitch integration that doesn't require the streamer to download anything. It's a standard mod. So far it's been used for Climb. Climb, what does your what does your mod allow as an integration? What does it let chat do? The base mod simply tells the game what messages chat is typing. From there, other mods can do whatever with it. Okay. So chat could type slash MES dot spawn dot planetary cargo ship or nasty other things, something like that. What was the command to raise the threat level again? plugin's a torch plugin. When I magically get some time, Climb, I might hit you up for some info about that. That sounds like a lot of fun. And the sort of thing that Capac would get quite a big kick out of. He does quite enjoy his Twitch integration stuff on his streams. I'm liking using these poles for stuff. That was quite a lot of fun with Mars Horizon the other day. I have no idea how this is going to look from above. I'm really worried. Yeah, Perseus, I have seen the dummy engineer thing. But I've got Capac decoys, I'm fine, I don't need more dummies. And yes, I do know what I just said. No more dummy Capac. Let's have a look. That might need to get softened up a little bit, I think. It's gonna look pretty bad from drone views. I think overall it's making it look much more lived in, isn't it? It's amazing, it didn't... Like, I was expecting this whole thing to take a lot longer before I started feeling like I'd actually made something that feels lived. Thanks, Savoria. Homie. Could you get away with drifting in the food truck without... No. No, I could not. But also, I wouldn't be able to do any snow drifts for the food truck because it's a small grid, so I can't place voxels in it. It even shows up the crater really well. yeah, I might have to oops. Press the wrong button. Hang on, I think I have a better idea of how to do this. I'm going to get rid of it all. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk around imagining that I am actually moving as the vehicles and then do a matched track and do all the different directions. I think that'll give it the most believable appearance. Yeah, Beer Seeker. Having someone drive in front of me would probably make it easier, but it'll be fine. She'll be alright, mate. You probably could do some blending with the normal and the alien snow. The trouble is, I think it'll either be I think it may end up looking a bit odd because the main difference is the color, not the texture. Okay, let's move the Gookie back. And park it up. So maybe I'll start over here. Goofy and the crane. I knew these tracks were going to be one of the toughest parts to make look good because I don't want to do too much voxel editing around them. I'd rather just have them be flat on the terrain, which is going to make it harder to make them look as good as other bits, but will also make them easier to drive on. Because those of you that have played Lost Colony or Frostbite would know that some of those tracks, they're difficult to drive on, but the ones that aren't must have taken days to do. So, first up, we'll have it like it reversed. It drew forward and then reversed in. So, that means this wheel would go somewhere around up here. Let's follow it. Good. Then we would have then imagining that this would be the way we drove in. Going down past the arboretum. Yeah, Morthus, I'm not gonna do the dug in or snowdrift beside it tracks. I'd sort of like to, but I just worry that if I go that length, I'm actually going to end up with things taking either too long or being a nightmare to actually move around on. Yeah, generated terrain is much better to drive on for so many reasons. And I also want to come from these tracks and go out and left. that. How's this looking from above? Looks a bit more believable for that section now, doesn't it? Let's put the road where you have a bit more of expectation to find it. Yeah, I was planning on adding some dirt and stuff into the vehicle parking areas, but I thought I'd just start from the parking areas and make the tracks so that they kind of make a bit of sense. And then once I've got the tracks making sense going to the various buildings, I'll be able to fill in the other gaps and make everything else kind of work too, I hope. I'm just going to pretend that these two have the same wheelbase. Because trying to thicken it out will probably end up making it just look messy and kind of get rid of the story element of it all. Well, you know what I mean by the story element. So when you look at the path, there's an idea that's immediately in your brain of where things have gone, where they've come from, what's happened before. There's a story there that's immediately in your head. Oh, when's the next Lego stream? Lego stream. I'm hoping I can find time for one next week. I was originally thinking this week, but then I realized that I needed to do my big year celebration in Survival Impossible, so it wasn't going to work, but there's a small chance it could be next week. I will post stuff in places like Twitter and whatnot once I've decided when. So, and of course Discord. So as long as you keep an eye on those, you'll get an idea of when. I'm doing a thing, and I don't care who knows it. That was from a drone, I think. And then we'll go around down here, off into the distance. You need two people standing on the back of the truck painting the ground as you drive around. That's a great idea. I wonder how well it would work. Capac and I have talked about doing some competitions in Space Engineers numerous times over the years. It's a real challenge to come up with a competition that's fun for both of us and doesn't end up with just it being a foregone conclusion of, usually because it's Space Engineers, me winning. And there are a few reasons we don't like the idea of playing around like that, because if people assume I'm going to win, it's not fun for me, because then if Capac wins, it's really bad for me. If I win, it's boring for everyone. It's just really awkward. So we really need to find stuff that neither of us really care about, but we still want to win because it's pride. And something that's stupid and fun enough. So it has to be something short term to fit any of those sorts of requirements. Yes, Tagir, I've got about 150 hours in Avorian. I've played Avorian a fair bit, but it's a terrible game for content creation, to put it bluntly. It is a fun game to play, but it is a very, very slow game to build in. So it's not a great option for content creation, because like Survival Impossible is slow to make content in. Avorian, when I've done it in the past, was even slower. But yeah, fun game. If you ever liked Eve and you wanted it to, like Eve Online, and you wanted it to be less spreadsheets in space and more single player, you should have a look because it is fun. Yeah, yes, yeah, it is a long game. And the designing definitely takes a lot of time. Alright, let's have another look. What do you guys reckon? I think in terms of the paths, that kind of works. I know my track widths aren't perfect, but they're not too bad. Jexum, you keep that headcanon intact, buddy. Okay. So now I feel like I just got to give it a bit more detail because of those lines that I've got in it everywhere. Oh, it's going to be the best way to deal with them. Probably using the sphere. I'll need to have a look at some other materials to try and give this a bit more blending and variety. Yeah, tracks were mentioned in the late and what's been teased for the next SE update. I wonder what they actually are. My suspicion is they're decals, like the bullet holes. But decals in Space Engineers last a long time. Leodala, you should know why I spend so much time on ship design. I need my things to look pretty. I don't cope if I've just got mess and functional ships. Ugh, functional. If they're going to be functional, the function should be something ridiculous and pointless. But they should function well for that ridiculous, pointless thing. Yeah, that's looking a little less obviously on a grid. I think that's probably going to be about enough of this texture. I need to find another texture that I can put in here. Maybe that gravel from earlier would work. That was... Was it Triton Ice or was it Triton Stone? It was Triton Stone, wasn't it? Yeah, Wreath. It wouldn't surprise me if I run into some performance problems on this save at some point. But... I'm kind of... just resigned to the fact that that's going to happen eventually. Because there's too many things that I like, and I've already done too many subgrids, really. However, if I can manage to get off-planet a bit more, I could potentially do what I did with Survival Unlikely and have multiple saves. So one save per planet. And as I transition, I just edit around the fact that I've just reloaded the game. So for Survival Unlikely, for those of you who didn't know, the moon is a separate save. The moon and Earth are a separate save to Mars, which is a separate save to the alien planet. So I've got three saves. Yeah, or I could just keep upgrading my PC. Yes. I like this being mostly gravel underneath the truck. It could work. Yeah, it was a necessary evil for performance reasons that I separated everything into multiple saves. It kind of became an idea that I decided on when I transitioned us from the Survival Unlikely save to Escape from Mars. Because I obviously had to create a new save for that. And I love that even people who know this part of the story, and that I've got multiple saves, struggle to know exactly where I switched when watching the episode, which is kind of cool. I'm slightly chuffed that I managed to make this transition that seamless. Let's have another look from above. How's this looking? A little less shiny, which is good. What do you guys reckon? It was not the Void Station episode. Oh, wait. Was it the Void Station episode? No. Yes, Beano. There was some hidden manipulation behind the scenes of Survival Unlikely. I was the hidden manipulation. Capac, at some point decided to be aloof to it all, and so I kept him in the dark. Move the vehicles and look. Yeah, fair play. Ah, the Goofy can't even turn this fast. Let's put those on and see if it can turn this sharp now. Oh, it's not too far off it. All of you guys saying you're shocked. No one's that surprised. You guys know what I'm like. If it makes the video better, I will do it. Regardless of anything else. Alright, let's have a look from above again. I might need to soften up the crane spot, I think. And maybe spread out the dirt a bit. I'm pretty proud of my tracks, considering they're completely freehand. Then I just need to make the walking track down to the arboretum, really. That's now the main bit. Ah, Adirinen, you found the cockroach emote that you made, that I included. What else can I put? Alien soil, Triton bland, Triton ice. What's Triton ice look like? An oil patch out of uranium to torture yourself between mining it and parking your vehicles. Oh yeah, Manny Shed will get some tracks, don't worry. I'm just not at that bit yet. Yeah, Signa, I took the cockroach out of the series because it was OP. The power creep was getting very real with the cockroach, and especially as I thought at the time we were closer to shields than we were, I decided to ditch it. Decided to get it out of the game. And force us to use a vehicle that ended up being incredibly awesome. Capax bit a pill. So it kind of worked out in the end. So yeah. Sometimes for these things you have to make what is at the time an unpopular decision. Because in the long run I think it ends up better. But I think enough people give me some credit for having a vision of what I want it to be ultimately, so that I'm actually trying to achieve something rather than just blindly bumping about. Yeah, the cockroach was sort of the first. It was technically the first agglomeration because it was a combination of two of the what are they called? Oh man, how am I having a mental blank on the name of that ship? Scuttlers! Yeah. What does Paradise Rock look like? Bit too colourful. There's no way to get rid of bushes sometimes, Gilgamesh, unfortunately. None that I'm aware of, unless someone in chat knows one. Sequest Capac. Oh boy. I haven't come up with anything that I'm interested in to do with the water mod as yet. It hasn't quite. Yeah, I haven't found what I'd like to do with it. I've thought of some things, but none of them have really... None of them have really fit right yet. Water mod with no collectors allowed. That would potentially be a way to do it, actually. Because I kind of wanted to do a wrong way round. Wrong way down sort of idea with the water mod and have to get it all the way around the planet with water, but once I found out that collectors gave you infinite hydrogen, I was like, oh. Well, that doesn't work at all. Because that gets rid of all of the challenge. If you don't have a challenge getting power in station in Space Engineers, you pretty much don't have a challenge. Oh, that is too bright. Too bright. Oh, what else can I use around here to try and blend this a bit more? What do you guys reckon it's alright as it is? And if I just move the snowdrift over a bit more? Mostly water world, and you need to build submersibles. Maybe? That could work. That make it better or worse? I think that made it a bit better. That might do. I think I may be overdoing it if I push this further, mightn't I? Maybe next to the tree do something. Yeah. Was looking a bit clean around the tree, wasn't it? I just realized I've been doing all this painting at night, and I'm willing to bet that Steve can't see any of this for the time lapse. So I'm not going to see much. And the lights that I turn on when I'm in spectator cam, they're not visible to Steve either. Oh. I'm not going to do light poles because I'm not going to build anything in blocks during this stream. But I can show you something. Check that out. Speaking of light poles. That took me, I think, about something like 4.5 hours to build. It's so worth it. Look at it from a distance. Like, that is a shape that you don't expect to see in Space Engineers. Like, look at the layout of my base. I love this. I love that it's more organic and spread and... Yeah, I'm really happy with how this turned out. So that's completely connected from these buildings to where I'm going to be building the airbase down here. So that is piped up, fully conveyed, with a few turbines on it already and stuff like that. And yeah, I will be adding a driving path to the new area, but I'd kind of like to wait till it was daytime. But I can repark the vehicles now and then do the track off to Manny's parking spot. Oh, thanks, Ogre. Yeah, Ogre, I was talking about Survival Unlikely and what Capac and I are going to do in the future. We are going to be doing more together. Some of it will be Space Engineers, some of it will be something else. Now I have the joy of trying to reverse a semi-trailer with you all watching and me knowing I can't edit around it. Poop. That was close. Oh, my turning circle's not tight enough for me to adjust this angle properly. Yeah, I'm definitely not missing the old hitch. The old hitch sucked. The old hitch was an absolute nightmare. But this is kind of handy. An unexpected side effect of painting on the ground. Gives me a slight guide of where I need to go. Oh, hang on. Okay, wheels off. Yeah, because I am in creative and invulnerable and just doing voxel hands stuff. Trying not to do anything that might contribute to me surviving. I've got food in here that's more useful. This is all just stuff to make me look, make me feel like I live in a base that's real. There you go. Yeah, just a bit of groundskeeping. No, Omega, we should not do a Twitch Let's Dance. No. Should put burn marks where I crashed that drone. Well, I mean, it's got a covered over hole. No, the treehouse to base path has not been done yet. I should do that first before I go off to Manny's building. Capac buried under that spot. No, Capac is. Where did I leave Capac? I don't remember where I put him. Is he still in the office at the desk? I think he might be. Oh yeah, I should go show the fireflies. Yeah, Capac's right there. Let's have a look at the fireflies in the arboretum at night. Here we go. You guys are getting the first look, because I'll be showing this off in the video. I love it. It's so alien, so cool. This is really nice work, Ufo. This is such a it's one of those little touches that I just love doing to things like this. Oh. That's not ideal. We might want to fix that. Alright, I need grass, 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 grass. Where is grass? Come on. I'll do. Turn on some chill music and just sit here for a few minutes. I have not tested the launcher anytime recently because I've got so much from it that I don't need to launch anything down. And when I do next launch something from the launcher, I will be launching something redesigned because it didn't have enough parachutes on it. And thanks, Beers. Thanks, Dragnon, for giving Beer Seeker a sub. Where is that up to? Yeah, I might have to find some peaceful track over on Artlist that I can put into a mod, so that I can then put the mod track onto a sound block or a jukebox so I can hit play to listen to like some yoga music or something chill and silly like that. Like the kind of music you'd expect to hear at a yoga studio or something like that. Capac's playing Noita. Ah, that is a good idea, Mike. If I could figure out a way to get a decent shot of Noita when Capac's not home, because I'll need to use his PC. Oh, actually, no. We've got Steam Family sharing stuff, so I can use his library on my PC. So I could have a look at that. Have him playing Noiter on his on the programmable block. Now I want this one to kind of diminish to nothing, but then it'll just transition to being painted. Because I don't want it to be a ditch that I end up accidentally driving into. I do have plans on how I'm going to get back up to the armchair, the lawn chair. I will share them when I'm ready, because I'm not completely ready on them yet. But it's going to be a... First up, it's going to be a fuel lifter vehicle. It's going to be a small grid lifting large grid stuff. So I can get some... Even if they're small large grid tanks, some large grid hydrogen tanks up there. Then I can take the remora and explore further. But I also need to take a whole lot of weapons materials up there. Because Reavers. Idramok, I am going to convert the ship I captured into a tanker, but I'm thinking it's going to be a planetary tanker, so that I can go out and find myself a an ice lake and go and refuel it on ice lake with a fixed mining rig rather than having to drill snow, because snow is really painful and slow. Let's have a look at this. I think that's too straight for a walking path. It needs more of a bend to look right. Because much as people say people walk in a straight line, we actually tend to meander a little bit, like water. Or I could just do this. How does this look? Nah, it needs a little bit more of a path, doesn't it? Rather than just ending there. I can change it to daytime, but it stuffs up my time-lapse. Because Steve is recording right now. And I plan on using that time-lapse. No, Dragnod, sadly, you are correct. Voxel Hands is not granular enough to carve stairs. Oops. I just need to get rid of that thick of it. It's so hard to do this without having it look too consistent. Get that one. Paint! Why won't you paint? Maybe that works better. With the broken bit in it. What do you guys reckon? Do you think it looks better with the broken section? Because that way you've just got that little hint of a footpath coming off the driven bit, and then you've got the dugout section. Yeah. I thought this looked, yeah, I think this works. Alrighty. Yeah, less tracks are nicer tracks. That is true. And now, Manny's building. I've successfully greebled my greebles. This is true. And now. Oops, wrong way. Should work, and then I'm, oh no, I don't think I can justify going between the trees. I don't think that quite works. I think we might do this though. If you build it, they will come with a picture of a reaver. That would be a good poster. I'm quite happy with how this has turned out. It's going to need to start curving down the hillside and down towards the airfield. Alright. Sun's almost up. Cool. How far should I go towards the Fort Capax? Go down the hill. Gentle curves always look better. This is potentially going to make the base look both heaps better as I approach it from a distance, like when I'm returning from the launch area or something, as well as heaps worse when I'm approaching from a distance because of the way that voxel LODs work. It's going to be both very bad and very good, I think. So if you guys are talking about the wheels stuff that Keen has teased, they have teased what look like tracks on the voxel. So to me, they look like decal tracks, much like you'd see a bullet shot decal that follow your vehicles. I don't know how much they really do. And they've also teased the new wheels, obviously, new spotlights, that sort of thing. Yeah, I don't think a cert really give much of a care for me. That's true, PhD, but I figure I probably shouldn't talk about those sorts of things sometimes, just in case. Never know who might be upset by it. I don't think they'd care, but that's why I don't tend to, in my videos or streams, talk about rumored stuff. Just as a general rule. Especially since in the past, Keen have told me what the details of some of their updates were before they were published, so then I really couldn't talk about it. Okay, I'm happy with that side of this building. Did I do any? I didn't do any around here, did I? Let's do some snow drifts around here. I have not heard any rumors or seen anything to indicate when the... What are they calling this patch again? Whatever it's called. When it's coming out. Hello, artificial sunlight. Scrap race? Something like that, yeah. That's it. That's it. My memory is like a sieve lately. I hope there's a new scenario. I really enjoyed Frostbite. And even though Lost Colony kind of fizzled at the end, I still enjoyed it as well. I feel like there was a lot of learning that happened after Lost Colony and for Frostbite. Because, yeah, Frostbite wasn't perfect, but dang, it was fun. I think the scenarios are fun enough to play on their own, like to play solo. I mean, yes, playing scenarios with Capac does make it more fun for me, but I don't think you need to be playing multiplayer for them to be fun. I think they can be fun solo. Dang, dragged on. Thanks again, man. Yeah, happy with that. That's good. Can I bury some blocks and stuff in the snow? Maybe. I might save that for another one, another thing though, because I think I'd need to do some preparation if I was gonna plan to bury some stuff. That's gonna make it a bit rough to drive in there, but I think it's worth it. I don't think my performance has taken a hit. Frames per second. Well, it's not as flat. It was flat 60 before, so maybe. Maybe this has done me some disservice. Is it saying 51? Once I stand still. I've got plenty of room to move though. As this is what I'm running settings wise. I can drop those down significantly. Memorializing old rovers by having them like a burnt, like a rusted out tractor in a field sort of thing. Tree draw range is huge for better aiming. Oh, but I do love it. Look how far away you can see the trees on the mountains. I love that it's so far away. It's awesome. But yeah, I've got room to move to drop stuff, which is good. Okay, let's add some more snowdrifts over here. No, Amaru, I did not do the pipeline on stream. I did it yesterday when I was recording. Because apparently my stream rig is not capable of both recording and streaming when I'm playing in 4K. Because it used to have a better CPU in it, but the CPU I had for it died. And at the time, I just had to get something maximally affordable, so I've got a fairly terrible i3 in it. So I can't really handle what I need it to handle. So I may end up having to invest in getting a new CPU for that, for my stream rig. Which is unfortunate, but it is what it is. No, the terrain editing is not a mod, it's voxel hands, which is a default creative mode tool. There a bit. Space Engineers hits both CPU and GPU. I don't think it's... I'm not in a position to say which one is more, because I've always built my PCs around... Well, ever since I started on YouTube, I've been building my PCs around creating videos and stuff, so I've felt somewhat more justified in spending stupid amounts of money on it, on my upgrades, that I probably wouldn't have spent if I was just playing for myself. And you can thank people... I suppose I should say, and partially thanks to people like you guys who've been dropping massive sub bombs, Tracknon, and such, and Mackle and DC Viper and all the others. DMOS, yes and no. OBS, yes, can stream and record them both at the same time, but. You were here at the start of the stream when I stopped recording and everything started playing nice again. I think it's the... My stream rig is at its limit trying to record 4K footage. And then adding to that, that it's having to downsample that 4K to 1080p, it's too much. And apparently, even though it looked fine on my end, the experience for everyone on Twitch was abysmal. And I think it's CPU load dependent because I've previously had some issues when recordings have been stuttering and the CPU usage has been at 100%. Here we go. We have morning. So have a look at this in daylight. Drop pod snowdrifts. My internet cannot handle a 4K upload. I'm in Australia. Come on, man. I can't even watch 4K. I think it's a miracle Capac and I can both stream at the same time. Just having a look at this in the daylight. Let's have a look. Yeah, I mean, I'm compared to a lot of other people in Australia, and I know there are many places in the US that have particularly bad internet, my internet connection's not bad, it's just not good. It's good enough, but yeah, not for 4K. See, this is what I was talking about with at a great distance, it might look horrible. It's not as bad as I thought it might be, as I feared. See, I've got above average by Australian standards internet, which would be unusable internet by South Korean standards. Yeah, Idramuk, ironically, at the place Capac and I last lived at, my 4G connection was better than my NBN connection. So if I wanted a really good connection, I could just switch my modem over to its 4G backup. And I, with that, was getting, I think I got 120 megabits per second down and something like 40 up through 4G, which was nuts. How do I feel about the reflection on the ice? Yeah, it's okay. Some parts of Australia have fiber internet. I do not. I have fiber to the node. Demos, because at my current place, 4G, my 4G is terrible. I'm in a signal black spot. So what do you guys reckon? I'm pretty happy with this. This works. And I think it looks okay as you go out, because it blends in. Yeah. Well, I might wrap up this stream here, because I don't think I'm ready to do the stuff down to the aerodrome yet, because the aerodrome needs to be laid out before I can really do much. So, yeah. I think this is enough to get some really cool flyover shots for the 1 year celebration. Well, thanks for coming along, everybody, and thank you for all of the tips and suggestions, because it's been really, really helpful. I haven't done a lot with voxel hands, but, and obviously I haven't dealt with much snow in my life, so knowing where to put the snow is kind of helpful. So all of that was quite useful. Capac and I will be back tomorrow at the same time as this started today, with some more stationeers. We are hoping to launch our rocket. We've done some prep off stream, which should make that possible, we hope. So I'm really looking forward to that. And yeah. Then Survival Impossible on Saturday. Says all that and plenty more to come. And I will see you all then. Thanks for coming, everyone. Hope you have a great day.